Well, good evening. I know you said good morning. It's not. It's actually a... Oh, it's not far off. It's 11:45, just gone. And I decided, as I'd been sandpapering away on this fork here, which I believe is actually alloy, yeah, the paint at the end is absolutely fine, it's just in the middle there. And I mean, just look at that shit on the floor. It's all white dust. There's a lot of white dust underneath it. The metal is fine underneath all the white powdery stuff that's come off. But I think I may need to get a drill or a wire brush attachment for a drill, because that's one thing I don't believe I have. Oh yeah, in case you're wondering, this is a bit jerkier on external power, but I've actually found that the Dell charger adapter for my Dell Pocket PC actually fits on this. It's 5.4 volt. It's pretty damn close, but it is. Oh, it is panning all right. It just seems to be weird when it hits that light. I don't know why. Well, it looks weird on my screen anyway. I've got the chance to go at Mum's tomorrow. I'm not sure if I will. I might. I don't know. And speaking of which, my brother's messaged me. He probably wants me to go over just to sort his laptop out. Yes, boss. He just messaged me saying, don't forget to bring your Windows 7 disk, spare hard drive just in case, and chargers. I don't see why I need to bring a charger, though, because... if the charger from the other Acer laptop that he's selling me fits the one he wants to keep, he might as well keep that. I've got plenty of chargers here. There's no point, you know, me taking another one out there. Yeah. I don't know. Yeah, I've got... disc here I'm going to be testing later. Yeah, that's the only reason I put the camera on, really, because I'd noticed all that, so I thought that was worth starting tonight, and I found the external power supply, so I could, if I really wanted to, you know, save on battery life. Could just use the external power supply. Is it getting hot? No, it's not even getting hot. I've been running for, hang on, nearly 4 minutes. But then again, if this camera's drawing more than 2 amps, then I think there's something wrong with the camera. So yeah, it's seems to be running this all right with no problems. Not that I've noticed. Right, I need to find my 32-bit Windows 7 disk. It's gone walkies, I keep losing disks. I hope I actually haven't lost it, because I would like to duplicate it like I've done with my 64-bit Windows 7 disk. Just because I like to have both. Even though I don't actually think I need a 32-bit. Because if I ever wanted to downgrade the main PC, that's 64-bit, or capable of taking 64-bit. It's 64-bit on my spare one, down there. The laptop that my brother's got is capable of taking 64-bit, so... but I do like to have it there just in case, you know, I come across... oh, actually, my laptop, that's 32-bit. I haven't left the disc in there, have I? I'm just thinking. I might have left the 32-bit disc in something. What was I playing with last? What did I put Windows 7 on last? Was it my other Acer laptop? I get a lot of Acer laptops down the recycle centre. Might be. It might be worth me just powering up the other one. I can't remember if I reinstalled Windows on that one or not. I'll have to have a look. Maybe not tonight, because I don't need it, but I'll have a look at some point. Right, well, as I'm going over to Mum's tomorrow, I'm going to see if there's a wire brush attachment in the workshop I can borrow just to... I'll clean all that off properly. And, may actually clean that all off and see if I can drop the forks out, mask up the everything else, and just get a can of black gloss spray and a can of primer and actually do a proper paint job on it. Yeah, fuck it, why not? It's gonna cost a tenner in paint. £10 worth of paint to use about half a can of each, if that. But hopefully with a proper paint job on there, that'll prolong the life of the aluminium. I think that's an aluminium thingy. I haven't got a magnet at hand to try it. I'll get one off the fridge later and we'll have a try. Anyway, I'm going to disappear for the night. So, I probably will go over to Mum's tomorrow, I'll take my toolbox. Oh, and look what I found, actually, speaking of tools. Did I drop it in there? No, it's on the floor. I found my vault stick. It was actually underneath the blade of my Lego bulldozer there. That's why I couldn't find it. It slid under there. Because, well, as you can see, I've completely cleared that bench of all the loose Lego that was on there. At least half of what's... I can't see, hang on. Half of what's in that tub came off of this bench. It's no wonder I had no friggin' room. Whoops. No friggin' room up here, really, isn't it? So, yeah, I decided to have a big old clean up. So that's going to keep me busy one day, clean when I can be asked. Sort that tub of Lego out. When I can be asked. Yeah, that's gonna... That's worth me doing a proper job on that, isn't it? And then maybe I'll be able to find a better one of these in my box and a better spacer. Pardon me, yeah, alright, then I'll do that. Look at this little one, it's wiped that, look. Anyway, I'll talk to you again when it's daylight. Okay. Well, you can see it's daylight now. He's moved again, he's moved from round about here, level with the speaker, to there. It just moves in small, I can't think of the word, you know what I mean. Whew. So far today, all I've done is check that the disc works, and it does. So I've now got two. If I knew where the 32-bit disc was, I'd do that as well. So what I'm doing, I am waiting for Mum. She's going to be about another 45 minutes or so yet, so I figured if I can get the hex key out, I'll get the rest of the parts I need off of this bike. Best set of hexagon keys I ever bought. This was a Lidl set as well, to be honest. I think it's got Corsair-V 5mm. I'm just going to take a handful of tools to Mum's. Well, that came off really, really easy. Brake blocks are in fairly good condition. I can reuse those. So, it just needs a clue. And what the hell is that stuck to my finger? Piss off. Something stuck to my finger there. Right. It has a lot of nuts and bolts on something like this. That are 5mm. These are smaller. I think they're 3 or 4mm, I can't remember. That's also a 5. See, depending on the type of derailleur you have, some of them will be a 9mm nut, some will be a 5mm hex. Take that off. I was going to replace that anyway, wasn't I? So, chuck that in my box. There's some good metal underneath all that crap, and I've cleaned it all off. So it just needs a good clean down for preparation and a repaint. And like I said earlier, or last night I should say, I'm going to spray it. So I know it's only a small little area, but provided I can drop the forks out of here, I'll spray it with spray paint and do a proper job. Hopefully. I say hopefully because there's always a risk I could get runs in it, and I don't particularly want runs in it. Right, we're getting there. These bolts have a bit of lock thread on them, so I think it'd be a bit tough to get out. But I'd rather have that than go along the road and have the bolt fall off. You don't want your bolts falling out of your brakes, do you? That's never good. Even these rear blocks look okay as well. It was a well-used bike by whoever owned it before me. Or whoever took it down the recycle centre. Need two hands. Get off. You always get one that's got to be a little bit tight. Right. I'll just get this other one started. Then I'm going to flick it upside down. No, I'm not. Not yet. I'm going to grab my flathead screwdriver, pop the dust cap out of the top of the stem, and we'll see if we can get the head stem out and the forks out. I think I can get away with these brake blocks looking at them. They look perfectly good enough. In fact, I'm going to sort them so I've got the two rears together and the two fronts. If I can remember which one's which. Ew, on second thoughts, I may end up having to replace that one. It's a bit on the... Okay, the rear ones will need replacing, but front ones are perfectly fine. Right, I need your hand for some reason. And I've got to pop this out here. It's just a little dust cap, I'll put that back in. Right, now we need the 6mm. And all you do here, this bike Well, it doesn't like standing up now. Oh, that was actually rather loose. Not only is that quite scary that it was that loose, but it's also promising. Hang on. Now, will it or won't it? No. Bitch. No. It's seized in. That is a bit of a shame, really. I could still spray it, but it's going to make it a bit more awkward. Could try a bit of WD under there or something. That might free it up. But for now, I think I'll just have to do it the old-fashioned way. Right, well, apart from the apart from the shifters, the seat and the wheels, it's pretty much just a frame. Turn this PC off now. Just want to back up. Brother's bloody. Please don't forget. No, I'm not going to forget. Quit your bloody worrying, brother. Right. I'm going to have to go and get... I know somewhere in the workshop at Mum's there's a wire brush attachment for a drill. I may have to borrow that. Actually, I think there's probably a few over there. Bit of a dull, windy day today. Anyway, I better get sorted, and I'll talk to you when I'm back from Mum's. I don't know if I'll put that socket up, but I'll take my tools that I need out anyway, like my volt stick and my wire cutters. I might take my electrical tape just in case. All right, I'll talk to you when I get back from Mum's. I'm back from Mum's. Didn't quite go as planned, not entirely. And will you fucking focus? Thank you. Let's just give the Are we clean? We're clean. Cleaner. Anyway, yeah. Didn't quite go as planned, but I'm not going to go into details. But I can say my brother has a working laptop. So, we stopped off at the recycle centre. I didn't get a bike, but I got another chair. Let me just turn the lights on. I've got this tall bastard. yeah, I remembered to bring my spray up as well. I got, also from the recycle centre, a basket for Mum. She wanted a pink basket thing. I got some PS2 games. I got a game that I've been looking for absolute ages, Theme Hospital. Hard one to get hold of. I don't know why, but it's extremely hard. I do have something else. I got this, but I got this weeks ago. It's just been sitting in Mum's car. Now I keep, and I just kept forgetting to take it out. There's something else in there I'll show you in a bit. But I found two discs in each of these. One of them I've put in here. Grand Theft Auto 2 for the PlayStation 1. And Theme Park is in there, and that disc is in mint condition. Absolutely not a mark on it, so I can't wait to actually try that. Played it round to friends when I was at high school, and I've wanted it ever since. I've got this one, Brothers in Arms, Road to Hill 30. Discs are not that bad. And I've got this one, Tekken 4. With disc. And also found FIFA 09 in it, which... Bye! Wasn't me, not guilty. But anyway, I got the basket. Those two games, or those three games, four games, five games, however many fucking games there is, I can't remember. And that chair for £3. Oh, and that basket. Oh yes, and you may remember a video I did a while back. Can't see nothing wrong with that plug adapter, can you? Looks absolutely fine. There's some marks on it. Yeah, looks perfectly usable. Well, there's the plug that was plugged into it. It's actually fused that pin in there. Here's the other side of it. This is why I don't use these, people. Look at that. It's actually melted the shutters. That's what it's done. It's melted the plastic shutters here that we have on our plugs. The scary thing is, as well, that's the fuse right there. Neither fuse blew. The fuse in here didn't blow. The fuse there didn't blow. And it didn't trip out either. That's quite scary. Because like I said before, British plugs, we have a fuse in them. And that does look like the correct size fuse in there. Yep, 13 amp. So, it does actually make me wonder why the hell we bother with fuses in our plugs anymore. Because they just really aren't reliable. They really aren't. Just a few tools and a few bits again that I rescued out of the car because I kept it. Now, that is the laptop that I've still got to pay for. I bought off my brother. It is an Acer. It's an Acer Aspire. I can't bloody remember. 5742. Now, he was gonna was wanting £60 for this. I've taken the sticker off, but it has got an Intel i3 processor on it, which I believe is a dual core 4 GB of DDR3 memory. Did have a bit more than that, but again, my brother pinched a stick out of it to put in his. He pinched the charger as well, because this one, well, apart from this one being older than the other Acer, than his current Acer Aspire, there ain't a lot of difference. I ain't kidding. This top plastic is different because it's one of them where you can't just change the keyboard, which I've got to do on this one. You've got to take the whole top plastic off and change that, because it's all sort of molded in one. His one's got an i7 processor on it. I can't remember what he's got now, memory wise. I think he stole the 4 GB out of this, leaving me with the 2 GB. But underneath, when we flip them over like that, both his newer Acer and this one is identical. The battery, I know for a fact we could swap the battery straight over. This cover is exactly the same, the hard drive is in exactly the same place, memory is in exactly the same place, and the Wi-Fi card is right there in exactly the same place. And that's the other thing we had to steal from this one, because the Wi-Fi card on his one didn't work. And I'm guessing that's why the owners dumped the laptop. They couldn't get it, the Wi-Fi to work, it stopped working. So they dumped it. Even though it looked in bloody mint condition. I mean, this one's a bit battered. I can tell from the keyboard, and it's got a chip out of that corner, and the screen bezel itself. Yeah, it needs a bit of TLC, but I could bring this back if I want to. Well, I am going to bring it back to life. I am going to throw Windows 7 on this. Just what it came with originally. But yeah, we literally just took the Wi-Fi card out of this and threw it straight in his, and it actually installed and worked. But the one in it wasn't working. I wouldn't be surprised if that's the reason they threw it out. Instead of getting a little, one of those dinky little USB ones you can, you know, install on something like this, they just threw it out and decided to buy a whole new laptop, obviously. But seriously, that's the only thing we found wrong with it, was that the Wi-Fi didn't work. And that's all that's wrong with this one. Now the Wi-Fi isn't going to work. But it doesn't matter. I can soon sort something out for that. I'll try and find an original one to put in this. Well, it's just got to fit the socket, hasn't it? That's all. But it's a really diddy one. I don't think I've got any in my little collection of them. I have kept a handful of Wi-Fi cards from laptops I have dismantled for parts, but I don't think I actually got any that small or that new. Ooh. In actual fact, I've just realised I might actually have one. No, I've only got the sort of standard sized ones, you know, or the older sized ones. I've got a few of these. Several with the name Anatel on. Actually, I think they all have got Anatel on. They could all be the same bloody Wi-Fi cards then. No. Oh well, it was worth a little look, wasn't it? But I was just wondering if this piece of shit down here has got one on it. I don't think I took it off. I think I left everything like that on there, so I'm just going to have a quick peek. Is it still in here? And the short answer to that is no, it isn't. That's only because the motherboard's not in here. I found the... What did I do with the motherboard? Sure, I kept hold of it. I would have kept hold of a Wi-Fi card. Oh, I found my scissors. A transparent disc for something as well. I have no idea what that's from. That's that idea. That's that idea out of the window then. I'll have that out here. Right, get it off my finger. Certain I didn't throw the motherboard. I must have done, because it's not there. Right. There is, when I can find it, one more tub I can look in. And like I said, I got to... I didn't have to look far, did I? I found it. How about that for an old style Wi-Fi card? And that one. Small one, but the wrong style. Oh, hello. 512 megabyte. Something. something all over it. I'm not sure what that is. I'm pretty certain that's DDR2, that one. Almost dead certain, to be honest. Yeah, right, nope, don't have one. We'll have to have a look for one. Yeah, see if I can find one on eBay. I'm sure I can find something. Oh. Whew. Well, I got four of these office chairs now. But the reason I grabbed that one is because of its height. It would be much better to use that one here. And just as we were leaving, someone dropped off a chair just like the one I'm sitting on. But it's moving some stuff. But I thought, well, I've got this one, it's working, you know, it's all in working order for now, so I'll just get a replacement one as and when this one breaks. I'm trying to get hold of the PC mouse and I completely missed. Right. Oh yes, that's what I'm going to do as well. I'll find out up one of my cordless drills and stick on it when I can find it. I hope it's in here and hasn't fallen out. There it is. It's about the best one I could find. I'm sure I've got a different one here. Bloody sure I have. I know it's not in a toolbox downstairs, but I've got a box of just an, well, just odd tools over here. Ow! That hurt. Oh, no wonder that hurt. Melt on a spoke nipple. Fucking nipples! Oh shit. Drill bit. I'll be whinging one day because I can't find my drill bits. Yeah. There's a box of tools here. I might have something in here. I've got tools in here I could actually take downstairs. Actually, I think I will, to be honest. Because my toolbox down there is actually looking rather empty. Well, we've got a microwave lamp in here. Oh yeah, the big old sharpening stone that Cat's Custom Trikes gave me. Magnetic rod. Punch. No, a long screwdriver thing. Actually, I'm going to keep that out. Screwdriver, that can go downstairs. Those could go to hell. I'll keep the toffee hammer up here. But yeah, I think I'll keep that. Ooh, got hole cutters. Hole saws, I forgot I had them. Pencils. Bicycle spanner. Very fine file. That's, I wonder if that's a chainsaw file, actually. For it to be, I don't know. Dumbbell spanner. Spanner. Small pliers. Ooh, tin snips. Bicycle wrench, look, complete with a built-in tyre lever. It's taken me all this time to realise why the end was bent like that. Yeah, I don't make bike spanners like that anymore, do they? Another pair of pliers. What have we got? Another screwdriver. See, things like that I can take downstairs. Don't know about that. I've got a load of bicycle spanners downstairs, but I could do with a load of them up here. Another screwdriver. The imperial wrenches. I think they are imperial. They are, that's why they're in here. Well, I can't find any screwdrivers, there's another cable. Got the... Nemo, why is your ball in here? Got one of these tools with multiple keys on. I can stay up here, actually. Stubby flathead. One of my lamp hammers, I've got a couple more in the cupboard. No. I think all the wrenches I've got in here are imperial. Fucking microwave pressure switch. Buzz off. 21mm socket. Screwdriver bits, I've got tub for theirs as well. That's a 3/16. I haven't actually found what I was looking for. Found everything else, just not what I was looking for. Masonry bit. Ah. More hexagon keys have just turned up. Screwdriver can go downstairs. I've got enough screwdrivers through there, so I don't really need any up here. But I've got a box somewhere for all these screwdriver bits. I might as well bung those in there. Or, better yet, bung a few in my... No, I'll keep that up here. Bung a few of them in my... toolbox. I've got enough thingies. There's another bloody masonry drill bit, long one. I can't find me drill bits. Yeah, I'm just hearing myself whinging about it now. Oh dear. Oh, not there. Really, really long masonry bits. They can stay in here. Might even be why I put those other ones here as an old wooden level. That's just done it the world of good, hasn't it? Oh, the internals for a PIR sensor. I forgot I had that. Oh. I was actually pretty certain I was going to find what I was looking for. But I haven't. I found another drill bit. Several imperial spanners. Oh well, it was worth looking, wasn't it? Because you never know. Let's chuck these back in. Another masonry bit. Wondered why my pot of drill bits, masonry drill bits and whatnot, was looking a bit empty. I don't know why. Because I ain't fucking in there. Oh, go in there. Chuck key. I do actually have an electric drill that still uses chuck key. Can't see nothing in there. Oh, actually. One of those. I didn't think I threw them all out. I know I threw most of them out when I had a clean out in here, but I was just thinking I've got that FIFA game. It might as well go on the shelf to the collection with the others that I'll never ever play. Right, what I'm going to do is turn on. Actually, no, yeah. No, yeah, maybe. Definite maybe, I don't know. But I think I can get away with my little old Bosch for this. My little old Bosch, that's what I'm going to use. I ain't going to be able to do this one-handed, but in theory now, it should clean up this a bit better. Well, that battery lasted, didn't it? Right, I'm going to shut that down. I'm going to put that in my Clark, I think. Something with a bit more oomph. Where is it? There it is. And I'll be back in a little while. My battery died. You know, cordless tools are excellent. You know, because of the mobility they have. If you're not near a power outlet, you've still got power tools to use. But the problem is, if you're unlucky enough to only have that one battery, like I have for my Clark, you're a bit stuffed when the battery goes dead. That one's gone dead as well. It seems like you've got... The Bosch is good, but it doesn't hold charge in the batteries. What's this one like? I might have got a bit of life out of that one, but there's not a lot of oomph in it. Not really. Anyway, I'm just going to put my undershelf lights back on. Helps a little bit. I've got a coat on there, but I'm not sure how it's going to turn out yet. May end up running my wire brush over it again and doing another coat. I don't know. I'll see how it looks when it dries, but I want to clean up the frame as well, so... And I've missed a bit. Right, hang on. Right there, can you see? Whoops. Yeah, still a bit of cleaning to do on the frame, but I won't do that now. I'll wait till the paint's dry. Because I don't want floating bits of dirt getting into my paint job and making it even worse. Anyway, I have cleaned most of it up. Yeah, there's a mark here and there on the frame, but... So, second-hand or used bike. We call it second-hand over here, by the way. For those that may not know. Sure that fucking thing rises by itself. I'll tell you what, though. It's a bit awkward to get on. Oh, not anymore. But, yeah, no, that's going to be a bit more comfortable when I'm working at this table. That's why I bought it. I was going to get rid of that one, but I think I will leave it up there. Because at least if and when I have guests come over, I've got a couple of chairs for them to sit on. This one, the back needs to be raised on it. Here we go. I wonder if someone... No, I'm going to need two hands to do that, but yeah. I wonder if someone squidged it all down like that to get it into the car. I don't know why they threw it out. Seems to work. It does come apart in two sections. I'm not sure if it's broken or if it's meant to do that, but... When I went to put it in the car, I picked it up by the seat here and left the base on the floor. So, yeah. For £3, I can't complain, can I? It would have been worth a £3 just for the chair. That's why I like going down the recycle centre, you know. It's amazing what you do find down there. Maybe tomorrow I'll get to set this up. There's no booklet for it. It is just the disc. But I've been looking for that game for ages. I did buy one on eBay, but... Even though the disc said Theme Hospital, it wasn't installing Theme Hospital, it was installing something else. Not sure what the hell was going on with it, but it wasn't working. Ugh. Anyway, this is going to be a bit of a longer video because there's a bit of a discussion going on our Town Council Facebook group regarding the gates being left open because... For years, they locked the gates at certain times at night. Earlier during winter, because obviously it gets darker a lot earlier, usually at dusk, so during winter, I think 5 o'clock they got locked, I think, something like that. And during summer, I think it was around about 8, 9 o'clock, they get locked. But about a year ago, the council had, the town council has, had several townsfolk ask for the gates to be left open 24/7. So they did. Probably at the time, not really thinking it would cause the problems that we're getting now. The bottom line is, on a Friday and Saturday night especially, there's a group of, we'll say, youths, allegedly from the age of 13 to about 18, but that's just what people have said and what they're guessing, so anywhere around that age. In this town, I wouldn't be surprised if there is some as young as 13 in there. But they're actually congregating on the small toddler play area, the little kids' play area, and shouting, swearing, smoking weed, which really isn't a problem, not to me anyway. Drinking, I think I said that. Could be other sub... Well, I know there's other substance abuse going on that park, because... air pistols, the ones that use the little CO2 containers, canisters, and the same sort of CO2 canisters you get in these soda streams and soda makers. There's been a box full of those, all pierced and sniffed, found on the park. I've even found them out on my car park. I found a big box full, spread everywhere, actually. But by the time I'd picked them up and put them in the box with the others, it was a box full. Because nitrous oxide is in there. So, of course, they sniff that to get high on it. Or to laugh, you know. As well as laughing gas. So, yeah, and that's not... Even empty condom packets have been found around the kids' play areas. And the town clerk... has said there's been less complaints since the gates have been opened. I beg to differ on that, personally. I don't think the town clerk and the councillor are being utterly honest. But yeah, I've got this big discussion, and people that live... because it's over here, it's on that road over there. New Road, that one's called. It's where the fire station is and the community centre. You can actually access it from... the car park that's just over there. There's actually 1, 2, 4 gates on the park in total. Yeah, and of course people with their houses that back onto the park have naturally, and I think quite rightly, been complaining about the noise, because, well, if they left it like... it's now 5 to 11 almost. If they left at this time of night, I don't think anyone would be complaining, but it's the fact it's going on until 2, 3 o'clock in the morning and whatnot. People are complaining about that, which I think is fair, because one of them is actually a firefighter, you know. The last thing you want is a tired firefighter, because you've got some rat bags keeping him awake all night. And obviously people are calling for the gates to be locked again, because there was... this firefighter's lived on the same road for 15 years, and he said it's actually only just got worse. Now the gates are being left open. But again, it's that classic thing where you get a handful of hooligans, hoodlums, ratbags, pricks, call them what you will, spoiling it for everyone else. So I said, what we need to do is find an alternative solution than closing the gates again, which could either a solution or a deterrent to get rid of them, so we don't let those prats win and spoil it for the rest of us. Because it happens all the time, you know. Something nice will come along, your town council will do something nice. You'll get some fucking ratbags come along and either vandalise or do something, and the council have no choice but to take it away and ruin it for everyone else, just because of these one or two pricks. And it does piss me off, because it's not fair on those that do want to respect it and do enjoy whatever it is. I mean, I actually said to Mum when we were in town last Thursday, which is our town's market day, we have a street market, and I actually said to Mum there was a hell of a lot of dogs and dog walkers out that day in the town centre. I lost count on the number of dogs I saw. And I think that's the reason why the park was wanted to be left open 24/7. So dog walkers who had to be up early had somewhere to walk their dog early in the mornings. So it's probably bloody nice this time of year, on a nice morning anyway. You know, walking around the park on a nice sunny summer morning. Thoughts to yourself, because you're probably one of the only few people on there, or even maybe the only person on there at that time in the morning. You know, or late at night when they get home from work and it's dark. So, yeah, it's not fair to them, is it? But what can we do? The park isn't lit, for starters. There's no lighting, so I suggested perhaps we should install some lighting, especially on the areas where they like to hang out. Because that's one of the, I bet that's one of the reasons why they hang out on that park, because it's completely pitch black, so no one can actually see them and identify them. So they can hide up easily doing all their illegal drugs and whatnot, and no one can identify them, so it can't be proved. And second, there's no CCTV or anything there to catch them either. So, ideal place for people that want to get into mischief to hide up. And we have a lack of police presence, but what I understand is we don't have a lack of police presence during the day. Nearly every time I go out during the day, I will see at least one police car driving around, usually back to the police station. But oddly enough, never at night. So maybe the police could, during the known hours when these troublemakers are in the park, have a couple of PCSOs drive through the park, because the gates are big enough to get cars in, so the police cars can access it easily. Apparently that was one of the other reasons they opted to leave the park open, for easy access, which again is a good point. But the only problem is you've solved like a couple of problems and added another couple of different problems, so you know you haven't really gotten anywhere, have you? But a friend of mine is absolutely right, you know. The town council, they can't win. Whatever decision they made, whether it was to leave the gates open or closed, someone would have complained. So, it's not easy being a town councillor, is it? Come on. You know, they volunteer for the job. It's not a paid job. It's all voluntary. But you can't please everyone. So, no, I wouldn't say I'm cross at the town council for making what I consider a silly decision. But at the same time, part of me thinks it was a daft decision. Someone said leave one gate open when they're in there, or so they can get in there, and then lock that gate so they can't get out, but they'll just jump the fence anyway. Hell, I used to jump that fence a couple of times when I was a kid. So, my boss has just mentioned me in a comment. Abandoned trains, planes, ships and military vehicles. What up? Not sure what he wants me to do, because it's something he posted. A YouTube thing. Not unless he's posted it in the wrong group. I've done that before myself. Not. Get. Will. Watch. Bollocks. Watch. In a. Mo. Watching a Canadian on YouTube, so it's the word bollocks I said that made me think of this. And he was saying how us Brits, you know, poke fun at how Americans and Canadians say aluminium and we say aluminium, and he said there's no I before you. Well, in the British spelling there actually is. There is actually an I before the U, so it is actually aluminium. Eum on the end. But I actually said that, you know, the way different countries, especially English-speaking countries, say words differently and pronounce them differently, it's what make our accents interesting. Oh, that was it. He's been watching the British Top Gear. And he noticed that one of them put the word that at the start and at the end. And I am thinking he's referring to James May. I know Richard Hammond doesn't do it. And I know damn well Jeremy Clarkson wouldn't do it. So yeah, thinking about it, that actually sounds like the way James May would speak. But there's so many different accents in Britain. I mean, listen to mine. I'm surprised anyone can actually understand me. Good old Norfolk accent. Born and bred here in Norfolk. Norfolk, England, not Norfolk, Virginia. Yeah, what's with that? America nicking all our place names. I kid. Mind you, there's a London in Can't blah. I can't even say it now. There's a London in Canada, isn't there? In Ontario. Ontario? Ontario, that's better. Ontario. Can't complain at anyone else for fuck's sake. Let's try again. I can't complain about anyone else and the way they pronounce words, can I? Not really. Not when I can't even spit my own English words out. At least not tonight. I suppose my plan for tomorrow will be assembling as much of the giant to get back together as I can. The same with my Claude. I think I might just give it a second coat when it's dry and leave it at that. Pardon me. Oh, friggin' heartburn. Did I take my... Yes, I did. Oh, stepdad is okay. Well, like I said yesterday, they've put it down to a virus, but... Thursday, when this started, he did say he got scratched by a plant in the garden that, although it's not poisonous to humans, it can be to other animals. So we're wondering that whether if he's had some sort of allergic reaction, maybe. Because it's gotten better slowly. There is an improvement since yesterday. But, yeah, things didn't go to plan today because, let's just say him and Mum had a bit of a falling out. I don't take sides, though. I can see what he's saying. And there's also some things that I didn't agree with. And the same with Mum, actually. So, yeah, you know, that's why I don't take sides, because I don't see it from both sides. Oh well. I'm going to end the video here before I sort of wear the battery out. And it's charged up pretty... I actually swear it charged up faster with the external power supply than the USB. So, it's actually handy because I've only got two USB ports on the front. Three, if I count the one on the card reader. So, a bit of technology that isn't used a lot. The card reader, I mean. The memory cards are still used, you know. They're used in cameras like mine. They're used here, there and everywhere. In various forms and whatnot. But the actual card reader on a PC is... almost... what's the word? Void, you know. Not required. I still use mine because it's easier to pop the memory card out of this and just pop it in there. But that's the only time I really use it. I mean, my other camera I use to take the still photographs with, I just plug the USB cable in. You can do the same with your mobile phones now. You don't have to take the memory card out of your mobile phone or your cell phone, for those that don't know what a mobile phone is. I'm going to give up, I think, before... Yeah, I'm going to bed, I think, very soon. Yeah, you know what I mean. Lots of modern devices these days, you can just use a USB cable. So really, you need like 100 USB ports on your PC nowadays. Anyway, I'm going to say a good night, and I'll talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.